Hey, this is Iwona, and today I'll show you 5 keyboard shortcuts you need to know in Lightroom Classic. Hi, my name is Iwona and I'm a portrait photographer from Poland. You will find me on Instagram and on Facebook and also on my website iwonapodlasinska.com. And today I will show you 5 shortcuts in Lightroom that you have to know. First one is wherever you are. If you are in library mode, develop mode doesn't matter. All you have to do is click I on your keyboard and I is going to show you information. I as information shows you information about your file. In a corner, you will see the file name, date and hour when it was taken. And at the bottom, you will see the size of your file. If you click I again, you will see more information. So again, the file name underneath, there will be information about your camera settings and the lens that you used. The second keyboard shortcut is the letter O, but this one you have to be in develop mode and you have to go to crop. Whilst you're in crop mode, you can click O to see different overlays when it comes to your composition. For example, this one is the rule of thirds. And if you toggle through, you will get to, for example, this one, which is the golden ratio. And the next one will be golden spiral. And with this one, you can also hold shift and click O, and that would move that spiral around your picture. So you can put it whenever you want and frame your picture using this rule. And the last one that I like to use is this one, just because it shows me if I was editing that for someone else and that person wanted to print it with a different ratio that I gave them. For example, I set it to be 4:5, and if someone wants it to be printed 2:3, then this part and this part would be cropped out. Of course, if they didn't do any kind of manual cropping to that, that would be automatically cropped at the bottom and the top. And also you can click shift with O and have and see what would be visible if that was a vertical one. The next shortcut is when you have your masks on. And then you have your edit pins. Those little signs are edit pins. And if you take a look in here, it says show edit pins auto. So it means that whenever I have my mouse on the picture, then I see all those pins. And if I go on the side, they disappear. But sometimes you just don't want to see them at all. And in that case, you can either click and change it to never, which is fine, but there is a shortcut for that, which is H on the keyboard. If you click H, that is going to hide those edit pins for a moment, and you can click H again to show them again. And I'm going to show you how I use that. For example, if I want to use that heel tool to remove something, I'm going to make it bigger and remove like a bigger area here maybe. So I removed that and I thought I'm not really happy with what's going on over here and I actually want to put another one on top. I wouldn't be able to because if I hover over that, it only allows me to edit this one. But I actually want to put another one on top of that. This is when I click H on my keyboard and then I can put another one on top of the previous heel, like a patch tool, like a removal tool. And then I click H again to see all the edit pins again. So my third shortcut is when you are in the library mode and you're doing your selection, and there are some pictures that you don't want to have anymore. So for example, I have this photo doubled. And I just want to keep only one of them. It also happens when I'm scrolling through my pictures and I see some that are, I'm not going to edit anyway. So I just want to get rid of them. Then I have to click X on my keyboard and then it sets that photo as rejected. So like, for example, this one will be rejected. If I find a new one that's repeating, I'm going to click X on this one. And then after you're done doing that, you can go to photo and delete rejected photos. All, or you can use another shortcut that is not included in this video, but you can just click Command and Backspace, and that's also going to take you to those to delete rejected photos. And then you can either remove them from Lightroom, which means that they are going to stay on your disk, but Lightroom would not have the access to that, or you can just delete them from this, and this is going to delete that and put that in your trash bin. And the last one is a tricky one. It's T on your keyboard. That stands for toolbar. Toolbar is this thing here. And if you click T on your keyboard, it's going to hide that toolbar from you. And I had that once when my cat was on my keyboard and it pressed T, and for a very long time, I didn't know where to find that toolbar again. So if you have that problem, it's T on your keyboard and that hides and shows that toolbar. I almost never hide it, but I guess that someone has a very, very small screen, and you're, for example, like you're working on your laptop and you have a very, very small screen and you just want to get rid of any unnecessary part of your screen, that you can click T and you're done. So those are all my keyboard shortcuts for today, but there are many, many more. So I could do at least one more video with 5 shortcuts for you. So if you want me to do another one, just please leave a comment down below and like the video if you liked it. Or just let me know what you think of it, and I hope to see you again here on this channel. Bye!